We've already introduced the definition of the derivative, that limit-based expression for how we evaluate the derivative of a given function, but that approach is a little cumbersome. So what we want to do starting in this section is introduce the first of a number of different properties that will allow us to evaluate derivatives more quickly. So we'll start off by taking a look at how we find the derivative of constants, so just a number by themselves. But before we do that, let's take a look at a little bit of notation for derivatives. So there are going to be multiple different ways to indicate what we want to do is take the derivative of a function. So one way to do that would be to use the notation f prime of x. So f prime of x would mean find the derivative of our function f of x. Similarly, for some function f, we could say df over dx. So this means take the derivative of our function f with respect to x as that independent variable. If instead of a function f, we had an equation y equals something on the other side, we could write dy dx. Or we could simply put that d over dx notation out in front of our function. So four different ways of writing the same thing. Basically, each of those expressions means find the derivative. So find the derivative of that given function f of x, or of the equation y equals whatever on the other side. So our rule for taking the derivative of constants is that anytime we're asked to find the derivative of some constant, which would just be represented with any letter by itself, so the derivative of any constant c is always going to be zero. So in each of the following examples, we want to find the derivative of 2, find the derivative of 12, and find the derivative of negative 5. But again, we've got that being expressed with some slightly different notation. So in each of these examples, what we're doing is looking at the equation, in this case, y equals 2, which would be a horizontal line passing through y equals 2. In part B, not exactly drawn to scale here, but f of x equals 12 would be a horizontal line passing through y equals 12. And y equals negative 5 would be a horizontal line passing through y equals negative 5. Well, let me just write that again. Y equals negative 5. So in each case, we're asked to find the derivative of that given function. Each of these lines being horizontal lines means that they have a slope of 0. So as we move left or right along that line, we'd never move up or down at all. So a horizontal line always has a slope of 0. The derivative function tells us about the rate of change. So the derivative of the function 2 is just going to be 0 because the rate of change is always 0. Similarly here, f prime of x, which is the derivative of 12, will also be 0, since that rate of change is still 0. And dy over dx, which again just means take the derivative of y equals negative 5, will also be 0. So anytime we have a constant function, that's basically looking at a horizontal line, which has a slope of 0, so its rate of change is 0, meaning the derivative is just automatically 0.